this ambience about a concert hall, too, even before a band starts playing. From the time the doors open, you feel this place is electric, you know? That's one of the things I like most about the road, is that feeling of standing in the hall when the doors open, and you feel the excitement bursting into the hall. I must admit, I feel very comfortable there. I like playing live a lot.
Basic job as a musician is to entertain people, and I really believe that.
It's a great pleasure for us to be back once again. We've got a lot of things to do for you this evening. A lot of things from our Moving Pictures album. Right now, we'd like to do one of those songs. This is Living in the Limelight.
Approaches the unreal for those who think and feel.
setting for that Tom Sawyer mentality of having a very carefree stride and a very self-possessed kind of air.
The stance of it does definitely have a modern-day rocker's persona about it.
A modern-day warrior, mean stride. Today's Tom Sawyer, mean pride.
We'll be right back. steam the forest, and the trouble with the trees. For the maples warm from sunlight and time, we hope to know their peace.
Simplify a motivation or simplify a moving force in our music, that would probably suffice.
Thank you.
a song by a car. This is called Red Barchetta.
Well, it seems to me that a car has been one of the standard metaphors, and volumes have been written about the sociological and cultural impact of the car and what it represents. But it also has a very fundamental sensual appeal, and it's a metaphor for sexuality and for freedom.
driven by the principles that first made us interested in it, in terms of the freedom of choice and the type of material that we would play, and the expression of music that we felt was exciting and good would excite other people as well.
Let's go.
An artist, first and foremost, before his audience, has to do something that's stimulating to himself.
I mean, the only real reason for us to be doing what we're doing is the results, is our work.
We'd like to do something for you from our Farewell to King Sound. This is called Closer to the Heart.
Something that we just enjoyed doing. Geddy and I wanted to get a little more involved in the music and that we wanted to write things that were a little more complex. And when Neil came in, he felt exactly the same way. And he added that third element and gave us that push that we were looking for.
I think there's a very strong relation that's maybe not generally recognized between drums and between words, because the rhythmic structure and the phrasing and the rhythm of verse especially is very strongly rooted in the same kind of syncopation that drums are, and the same patterns of thinking overall work for me with words as much as they do with drum beats.
Ultimately, the most important thing about songwriting is feel. It sure helps to have good chops and to be able to play real well and to know all those notes, but the ultimate thing that someone listens to is, is the feel of the song. It's really the emotional aspect of it.
Together to ignore your hate.
songwriting that's important, and it's playing really well on stage that's important, and it's going to make the difference between feeling good or not feeling good. And when I walk off stage knowing that I've played well or close to as well as I can, then I feel very satisfied. You just feel good about what you've done.
The important thing has always been our music, so let's put the emphasis on that. You know, what we do after the show, or who we hang around with, or what kind of hairstyles we have, or whatever. It's just not important.